So what's up guys, basically I'm back with another video, and today's kind of going to be a couple things in this video. One thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open this box right here, if you don't know what it is yet. But Saab Viggen did get a couple gifts. They got this in, and then also, I'll take you in a minute here, I'll show you, I did install some iBok low ring springs on it. Now I was going to make a video on that, however, the whole kind of process of installing them was kind of messy. It was all over the place. We had to run around. And it just wouldn't have made a good, really good quanta. It just wouldn't have been a really good quality video, and so I decided against it. But today, in this box, we have a TurboSmart boost gauge. Now I ordered this about 2 weeks ago now, and it's coming in. And I'm gonna do an installation video. You'll see this later in this video. Instead of putting it in your regular position, I'm going to be taking out the headlight terminal and putting it in there and relocating the headlight terminal, and I'll show you guys how to do that and everything I'm gonna do. So if you have a Saab and you'd like to do it for yourself as well, you can. And I have a knife again. So we're gonna open this. It's a fucking sharp knife. Alright, so the first thing you get in the box is the TurboSmart gauge. Overall, pretty nice packaging. They just put it in a box and throw it to you, I guess. So I got this off of Rally Sport Direct, which is a company who have a lot of, you know, they have boost gauges, they have a lot of stuff for Subarus. If you have a Subaru, go ahead in there and go ahead and... Stop! Well, first off, we got the boost gauge. It is a 52mm face. And it comes with your, you know, your regular, your nipple for your vacuum line, your wires for the lights inside here, which I will also show you how to wire up, and then your mounting brackets here. So furthermore, when we get into the box, I'll show you what else there is in here. If I can freaking open it. So in the box, they also supply you with mounting brackets, washers, nuts, and a T. I'm not too sure what size this T is, but I'll tell you in a second here. And then they also supply you with, I believe, vacuum line. They supply you with a good amount of vacuum line. They also give you a little guard here for the pod. It goes over the pod like that. Makes it look, you know, sick flush. And yeah. So for the actual installation of the boost gauge, I'm going to be replacing this right here, which is the headlight terminal. Now this simply just pops out like that. You can relocate these wires, and I'm going to be relocating this headlight terminal, which I have HIDs wired in, so it actually doesn't do anything at all. All that does for me is lets me flicker my HIDs, so it's not really important to have that in like arm's reach. So where I'm going to be relocating that to, I will be relocating the wires down, and I'll be cutting a hole right here. Now I believe the hole is it's almost exactly 2 inches across, so I'll be putting it right here, and I'll cut it out with a Dremel, measure it out, and then you also have to, when you're doing this, modify the, you know, the hole like this, so you have these lips that come off which hold this on, so you can hear it clicks in. So that's going to be modified there, and then I'm going to route power from the dimmer here straight to the boost gauge. So first off, you're going to start by removing this T25 and these T25 over there. And then you will take off the panel here, which is just sitting over there. You'll take off the panel and you remove these two T25s as well. There's a 10mm right here. You'll also remove that. And once you have it pulled down, there's one more T25 right there. Dash will just pull out. Now you're going to have to kind of shimmy it around this here like that. But it should just pull out like that. Keep it close because we are going to need it soon. So now once you're back here, you're going to want to come up and try and find where that headlight is. I find the best place to look actually is just right up here, right by this plastic sheet right here, this metal sheet. Look right up there, you can actually see it right there where my fat finger is. Now then you're going to have to take out these, which are really easy. Once you have that out, you should just be able to push them behind and they should just pop out. So now once those are out of the way, you see you have access to this wire right here. And you're gonna stick your hand up, as you can see my hands right here, and you're gonna grab it and pull the wire down. Now, here we have the said wire, and so now this is the assembly for the light switch up there. And now once that's out, you can go ahead and put these guys back. They should just push in like that, and like that. The gist of this mod is to be, you know, giving you a nice easy place where you don't have to go and buy a $120, you know, vent bracket or anything. So what we're gonna do is we're then gonna take this guy here, and you're gonna wanna measure out the exact diameter of this. You're gonna want the exact diameter of this measured out. And so when you get that, make yourself a template of this. Then once you have that template, put it where you think would be, you know, the best fit for you. Right here, it's gonna be good for me because it's out of my knee, you know, I'm not gonna be hitting it all the time when I get in the car. So for me, I'm going to put it right here. I'm gonna cut it out with a Dremel, and then I'm going to sock it in. Now, like I said before, you have to recreate those little grooves on it so it sits in. If you cannot recreate the little grooves, I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to, but we'll try. If not, then, you know, like a silicone will work to keep that in. What I'm gonna do first is take a Dremel and make room for said boost gauge to fit in. So here's the boost gauge, and so I'm gonna just want it sitting right there. Now, as you see, if you buy it from TurboSmart or any 52 millimeter boost gauge, it actually fits in almost perfectly right into the stock position like that. So the only thing getting in the way is those grooves that you're going to be recreating on the kick panel. Now, once you do that, go ahead and grab your Dremel. And I definitely recommend, while doing this, to have a good Dremel and a good Dremel kit. It makes it so much easier. For this particular scenario, we're gonna be using something soft, not too abrasive, because it is plastic. We don't want to crack the plastic or, you know, create jagged edges. So I'm gonna be using one of these soft abrasive pads right here. So now I'm gonna go ahead and Dremel down these skirts right here. Spread your imagination to the millions. Don't worry about how to maintain all your millions. Just spread that positivity for the children and all of the haters that's hating. Just love them, cause that's the only way you ever gonna kill them. No, somebody feel them. Last but not least, put your ego on the shelf and remember, love yourself. No, no, no. Put your ego on the shelf and love yourself. No, no, no. Put your ego on the shelf and remember, love your member, love yourself. Now, ideally, please use safety glasses. I didn't do that, and I got a bunch of shit in my eye and, you know, shit everywhere, so just vacuum that up after. But that is what you want. Now, I just found out that you don't even have to use silicone to keep this in. If you get a nice tight cut and keep checking it every, you know, couple, you know, you go over a couple passes, check it, couple passes, check it. But even that, it sits in extremely tight, and you're not getting that out anytime soon. So when you put it in, make sure it's nice and straight, make sure it's where you want it, and, that will just sit like that, and then you're gonna do all the wiring after. So the only downside of, you know, test fitting it, making sure it fits tight, you're gonna have to get it after, so you can do the wiring, because it's gonna be impossible to do the wiring like that. So pop these out, kind of with some persuasion, it'll slowly come out. I found a screwdriver getting on the side will work. One thing, do not worry too much about these blemishes on the side. Go ahead and clean it up with a file if you'd like, but the rim on this will cover that. So now for your next step, and this is probably gonna be one of the harder steps, is you have to find a grommet to go from the firewall into the engine bay. Now, I've read a lot of forums that there is a firewall grommet up here somewhere. And so I'm just gonna put on a time lapse and show you guys my struggles to get through that. And then I'll show you a little trick once you find it. We're underneath here. The grommet you're gonna wanna be looking for is that one right there. Now that grommet has a bunch of wires going through it. And I'm going to show you a trick of how to get past those wires. All right, so long story short, I had a couple friends come over and help me, and now we kind of have it figured out and situated. So if you look down here, I could not find the usual grommet you go with, so I decided to go with this one right here. If I can get the camera to focus here. I went with this grommet right here. This is right underneath your clutch pedal, and it goes from right here around from there, and I rerouted the vacuum line. It comes up through there at the hole. You're gonna have to kind of reach your hand in the hole and up like that to get it out. Now that same one comes around here, and if you guys can see, follow that vacuum line back, comes out under here. You're gonna have to take this lid off, and then you're gonna reach around with your hand and pull it out. Now, because the grommet's super stiff, there's a trick I used. I took a pen, I cut both ends off. Use that middle section, you push it through first, and then you push the vacuum line through. Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take that same vacuum line, come over here, they supply you with this T, you're gonna cut, so for my car, I have the solenoid delete. So if you, I'll put the link for that in the description below. It's really easy to do. If you have a tuned car, which is a stage two, you should always do that. It just breeds boost so much better. So I only have one vacuum line going for my bypass valve, and usually would go and read manifold pressure right over here. So I'm gonna tie into that one right there. And so I'm just tying into that one. That's where it's gonna sit. And now basically everything under the engine bay, we are done. So then what you're gonna do next is you're gonna, you know, button it up, make it look a little bit prettier now. Keep the vacuum line so it's not gonna fall down anywhere, so it's not gonna, you know, screw off on you or fall in the hole. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the dimmer switch, which looks like this. You're gonna take the dimmer switch out, which is, now you have the dash exposed, you can just come back here and pop it out. And then you're gonna take the clip off. And so now what we're gonna be doing is we're going to be soldering to these wires. So a little update, I'm just gonna put this in between two clips here. I got the light working, works perfectly. I was really stupid and I got the wires wrong and I was being dumb. Anyway, the wires you're gonna want from here is the green wire and the white and black wire. Use a test light to figure out what's exactly for your car, but that is the wire you're gonna want. I believe it's green and white, I can't quite remember. I know it's green and black and white though. So you're gonna tap into those, positive is the green, negative is the black, and then you will have a working light. And I found out if you do it to the dimmer, which is why I did it, you can actually, you can actually dim it still, right? And I figured out it works if you want night mode. You'll see here, it still works in night mode. It doesn't get too dim, but it gets dim enough, so it's not too bright. But anyway, yeah, all figured out, set and done, and I hope you enjoyed this video. So weird little fast forward here. It's like a month since I recorded this video. I tried posting it, didn't post, and then I got lazy, and then school and grad and everything, I got kind of distracted. So basically, I, in the video, showed you I fixed the boost gauge. First time I did it around, I got the wires messed up. I went to a buddy's house, we fixed it, wires work. The car is currently still sitting out there. Boost gauge works perfectly fine. I did have an evap issue. So I had to fix my evap issue and now I'm making full 22 pounds every single pull, which is what that stage two should be pulling. And yeah, so I hope you guys all enjoyed this video. If you want, you know, have any questions, please leave them down in the comments. I know some of this was a little confusing and, you know, the whole wiring thing's a little confusing. So if you have any questions at all, please don't hesitate to ask. Now I did mention at the beginning of the video, I did put Eibach lowering springs on this, my Viggen, and I'll actually show you that right now. It lowered, they're supposed to lower about an inch and a half, an inch on a Viggen, I guess. The front still, it doesn't look too slam, but it still looks a lot lower. But the rear is where it really starts to tuck, and no, definitely love how close it gets there. And yeah, sometimes it's it doesn't scrub actually on 225s. If you put 235s on, I haven't tested it yet. I think you'll just be fine with 235s, but it definitely makes the car look a lot more aggressive, a lot lower, and handles ample times better, not gonna lie. And no, definitely a big fan of these springs. I got them for $100 out of a shop. They were sitting there for a while, and I decided to pick them up, put them in the Viggen. Other than that, yeah, that's all for this video. And thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next video.